What's up? Welcome to the courtroom.
I am Theo.
And I'm Oj. And in this podcast, we tell stories about people's life, liberty, and property.
Kukwentohan namin kayo about court rulings in a way that will make you understand jurisprudence like a 9-year-old.
All persons before the Supreme Court of Justice, just give an attention for the court now consent.
So join us as we delve into true crime, political controversies, and all things tatay de chismis every week.
Evelyn Chua-Qua is a teacher at Tay Tung High School in Bacolod City, while Bobby Qua was a grade 6 student at the same school where Evelyn was teaching.
Class advisor ng grade 6 noon si Evelyn and isa sa mga estudyante niya si Bobby. Ngayon, may policy kasi yung school to extend remedial instructions to its student. And isa si Bobby sa mga students na magre-remedial.
Nakapag ganyan ka ba, Teo? Yung remedial classes?
Hindi. Talino ko eh. Wow. Elementary uso to, di ba? Sa school kasi namin, yung mga, normally yung mga nagre-remedial lang, yung pag may back subjects ka, back subjects? To college. De, yung parang kunyari bagsak ka last school year. Yan, yan yung mga nagre-remedial class namin. So far, hindi ko naman siya na-experience. Pero yun, hindi ka itatatanungin, Och. Malamang naman, hindi mo alam kung ano mga nangyayari sa mga remedial class bilang wonder kid ka nung bata ka.
Na-enjoy ko yung mga ganyan tingin mo sa akin.
Ay, gusto mo yan,
whether true or false. Hindi ako magkaprotesta. So, ano naman ang nangyari dun sa remedial class ni Ma'am Evelyn at saka ni Bobby?
Ay, marami. Eventful. More than just academic lessons. Tinuruan ni Ma'am Evelyn ang puso ni Bobby na umibig ng tunay.
Yan.
Hili ko kumanta. No?
So, the couple fell in love. And on December 24, 1975, they got married in a civil ceremony solemnized in Iloilo City by Honorable Cornelio Lazaro, the city judge of Iloilo.
Noong time na to, 30 years old na si Evelyn and si Bobby is just 16 years old. Kaya naman parental consent and advice was needed. Binigyan naman sila ng consent ng mom ni Bobby na si Mrs. Concepcion Ong and on January 10, 1976, their marriage was ratified in accordance with the rites of their religion in a church wedding solemnized by Father Nick Melicor.
However, on March 12, 1976, Tay Tung High School placed Evelyn under suspension. The labor arbiter required the parties to submit their position papers. And the school stated that Evelyn nga daw defied all standards of decency kasi she recklessly took advantage daw of her position as a school teacher. And she seduced daw a grade 6 boy under her advisory section into an amorous relation.
The school raised issue on the fact that Evelyn daw stayed alone with Bobby dun sa classroom even after school hours when everybody had gone home. Tapos nakalock pa daw yung isang pinto while the other door is slightly open.
On September 17, 1976, the labor arbiter, without conducting any formal hearing, rendered an award in favor of Tay Tung High School and granted a clearance for the termination of employment of Evelyn.
Well, sabi ng labor arbiter, although self-serving daw yung affidavit, di naman daw kasi tinanggi ni Evelyn that before her marriage to Bobby, an amorous relationship already existed between them, even during her employment as teacher dun sa Tay Tung High School.
And based din syempre sa undisputed written testimonies of several witnesses, that the couple manifested their relationship nga within the school premises and also inside the classroom and within the sight of some employees. Kahit wala daw direct evidence to show that the couple did immoral acts during this time, enough naman daw to imagine and conclude what ever transpired during the time.
Grabe no, Och. Dati pa pala madaming tamang hinala. Uso na pala yan dati.
Mga TH.
Parang pag mag-jowa, may nangyari agad. Di pwedeng, nag-aabutan lang ng love letters. Parang ako, conservative.
Affected ka masyado, no?
Hindi,
nangyari na ba sa iyon?
Ano tong labor arbiter, judgmental eh.
Okay lang yan. Kasi nag-appeal naman sina Evelyn sa NLRC or National Labor Relations Commission. They said na wala daw due process since di sila nabigyan ng copies ng affidavit na pinagbasehan ng desisyon ng labor arbiter.
Evelyn further contended that there was nothing immoral nor was it abusive and unethical conduct that is unbecoming of a dignified school teacher for a teacher to enter into a lawful wedlock with her student.
NLRC agreed naman and unanimously reversed the labor arbiter's decision and ordered Evelyn's reinstatement with back wages. Nag-base kasi yung NLRC sa deposition ng mga witnesses na si Maselioner, Despi, and Chin, who claimed that they saw Evelyn and Bobby sitting on the student desk inside the classroom after classes. Eh, bukod doon, they don't have any other statements naman na nagsasabing they were eyewitnesses to immoral or scandalous acts by the couple.
Tama! Sabi pa ng NLRC, they could not deduce anything immoral or scandalous about a girl and a boy talking inside a room after classes with lights on and with the door open.
Siyempre, Tay Tung High School didn't stop there. They elevated the case to the Minister of Labor. Ano problema ko? So, ayun nga, in-elevate nila yung case to the, dapat nata tinatagalog ko eh. In-elevate nila yung case sa Minister of Labor, who then reversed the decision of NLRC. Kaso may caveat dito, that Evelyn will still be awarded 6 months salary as financial assistance.
Evelyn, on the other hand, appealed the decision of the Minister of Labor sa Office of the President, and after several exchanges, the said office, through the Presidential Executive Assistant Jacobo C. Clave, rendered a decision in favor of Evelyn on September 1978.
And Tay Tung High School was ordered to reinstate Evelyn to her former position without loss of seniority rights and other privileges and with full back wages from the time she was not allowed to work until the date of her actual reinstatement.
Yan. Kaso, after 3 months, nagbago ng decision yung Office of the President, acting on a motion for reconsideration by the school. Honorable Clave modified their decision and gave due course to the application of Tay Tung High School to terminate the services of Evelyn as classroom teacher, but still giving her the separation pay equivalent to her 6 months salary.
And because of that, Evelyn filed a petition for certiorari. In response, the school argued that as a school teacher who exercises substitute parental authority over her pupils inside the school campus, Evelyn had moral ascendancy over Bobby, and therefore, she must not abuse such authority and respect extended to her. And sabi din nila that Evelyn violated a pertinent provision of Code of Ethics for teachers, which provides that a school official or teacher should never take advantage of his or her position to court a pupil or student.
On the other hand, sabi ni Evelyn, there was no ground to terminate her services as there is nothing wrong naman with the teacher falling in love with her pupil and subsequently contracting a lawful marriage with him. Sabi pa nga niya, kaya daw talaga siya tinanggal sa trabaho is because of the fact that she married Bobby.
So, sasagutin ngayon ng Supreme Court yung issue dito, which is yung romantic relationship ba ni Evelyn and Bobby, which culminated in their subsequent marriage, constitute immorality and grave misconduct sa part ni Evelyn as a teacher.
And syempre, aalamin din natin kung illegal nga ba yung dismissal na nangyari sa kanya.
Pero bago yan, may question din kasi if yung Office of the President ba, as represented by Honorable Clave, committed grave abuse of discretion. Kasi diba, binaliktad nila yung former decision nila eh.
Okay, so simulan natin sa question of grave abuse of discretion. In this issue, the court ruled that yes, Honorable Clave daw, in his capacity as Presidential Executive Assistant, committed grave abuse of discretion. Paano ka mo nangyari yun? Sige, Och, explain mo.
Ayos na. Biglang binasa sa akin.
Kala mo ako, no?
Ano nga ba sabi ng court dito? Well, eto, naalala ko na. Sabi ng court dito, they were at a loss kung paano nag-arrive si Honorable Clave dun sa reversal of his decision when it was based on unsubstantiated surmises and non sequiturs. Eto yung conclusion that does not follow from the premises. In short, yung decision niya based lang sa mga haka-haka.
Tama. In his original decision, Honorable Clave already pointed out that the records relied upon by the Acting Secretary of Labor were unbelievable and unworthy of credit. Bakit kamo? Ito, sagutin ko na. Una, yung mga affidavit stated that on certain time of the day after school hours, nakikita daw na magkasama si Evelyn and si Bobby sa classroom. Sabi ng court, wala namang kakaiba doon since it's a stated fact that Evelyn was tasked to give remedial instructions to her student. And saan ba pinaka-convenient mag-remedial class ang isang teacher at ang isang student? Eh di, syempre sa classroom. Besides, the affidavit daw is completely absent of specific immoral acts allegedly committed by the couple.
Isa pa sa napansin ng court is that the alleged acts complained of invariably happened from September to December 1975. But the disciplinary action was only imposed on February of the following year, that's 1976. What's more is, the affidavits were executed only in August. So, halata daw that all of it are just product of afterthought. And kasi apparently they didn't immediately act on the matter months after pa saka sila gumalaw. Kaya naman sobrang doubtful daw yung motives ng school for dismissing Evelyn.
Kaya nga nagtataka yung korte, bakit nabaliktad yung decision? I mean, both the NLRC and Honorable Clave naman recognized that the assertion of immoral acts or conducts are gratuitous and that there is no direct evidence to support such claim.
So, in determining if yung romantic relationship ba ni Evelyn and Bobby constitutes immorality and grave misconduct on the part of the teacher, the court answered it logically. Since there is no substantial evidence of the imputed immoral acts, it follows that the alleged violation of the code of ethics governing school teachers would have no basis.
That's right. The school failed to show that Evelyn took advantage of her position para ligawan yung estudyante niya. If na-inlove man daw yung dalawa despite their gap in age and academic level, then this only lends substance to the truism that the heart has reasons of its own which reasons does not know.
Uy, favorite i-quote yan ng mga simpatikong law students eh. Pero actually, di pa tapos yung love advice ng Supreme Court. They further stated that yielding to this gentle and universal emotion should not be so casually equated with immorality. The deviation of the circumstances of their marriage from the usual societal pattern cannot be considered as a defiance of contemporary social mores. Meaning, di porque unconventional yung circumstance ng pag-aasawa ni Evelyn and Bobby that already means they are rebelling against our social values, di ba?
Ganun. Oo nga. Tsaka sabi pa ng court, yung policy for the role of the teacher in rearing and educating children should not be capitalized para i-defeat yung security of tenure granted by the Constitution to labor. In fact, in termination cases nga, the burden of proving just and valid cause for dismissing an employee rests on the employer and his failure to do so would result in a finding that the dismissal was unjustified.
It is in this regard that the court declared Evelyn's dismissal unwarranted and illegal. Hence, the petition for certiorari was granted and the decision of Honorable Clave was annulled and set aside.
Tay Tung High School was ordered to pay Evelyn back wages equivalent to 3 years without any deduction or qualification and separation pay in the amount of 1 month for every year of service.
If you guys like this audiogram, please listen to the full episode on Spotify or on your favorite podcast app, where you can hear our insights on this case. Again, this is Oj
and Theo leaving you with a reminder to always look back in history because precedent shall rule the future.
Thank you for listening and we'll see you again in the courtroom.
Bye!